Hello friends, I am Mrs. Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to teach you, I am going to talk about Introduction to Optimal Binary Search Tree. What is Optimal Binary Search Tree and its simple example I am going to explain in today's video tutorial. Before going to Optimal Binary Search Tree, let's start with a binary search tree. BST stands for binary search tree. Here you can see that this is one tree, or we can say that a binary tree, where this binary tree is following some rule, some property. What is that property? So the property is all the elements in the left subtree of a root node are less than the root node, and all the elements in the right subtree of a root node are greater than the root node. Now let's consider root node 55. All the elements which are present in the left subtree, they are 35 and 12, are less than 55, and all the elements who are present in a right subtree, that they are 68, 61 and 92, are greater than 55. Let's consider 35 as a root node. For 35, only left child is present, which is less than 35. 12, which is less than 35, no right child is present. Now let's consider 68 as a root node. 61 is less than 68 and 92 is greater than 68. So every node which is present in this binary search tree follows the property, or sorry, every node present in this binary tree follows the property. That's why this tree is called as binary search tree. Now all of us are knowing what is the meaning of binary search tree. Now let's go forward for a next slide. Now let's consider I am having three key values with me. They are 10, 20 and 30. Sorry. Now if I want to construct a binary search tree from these three different values, so how many trees I can design, I can construct, I can build? So as three nodes are there, three elements are there from which I want to construct the binary search tree. For this, I'll start with first of all 10, the first element as a root node. So this 10 as a root node, if 10 as a root node, the next element, remaining elements are 20 and 30. So if I will insert next element as 20, it will go to the right child, to the 10, because 20 is greater than the root node 10. The next element inserted is 30, which will again go to the right side of the right subtree of 10. It will get compared with 20. Again, it is 30 is greater than 20, so it will go to the right side, right subtree of 20. But now currently 20 is not having any child, so 30 will get attached as a right child of root node 20 or parent node 20. So if 20 and 30 are inserted in a sequence, suppose if after 10 the next element is inserted is 30, obviously 30 is greater than 10, that's why it will get inserted as a right child of 10. But after 30, 20 is inserted, 20 is compared with 10, it is greater than 10, so that's why it will go to the right subtree of 10. Again it will get compared with 30, as it is less than 30, so it will go to the left subtree of the 30, and it will get as a left, it will get attached as a left child of 30. So in this way, these two different trees we can design, we can construct by considering 10 as a root node. Now let's consider 20 as a root node. If 20 as a root node, the numbers inserted are like 10 and 30. So 10 is compared with 20, is get attached as a left child of 20. 30 is inserted in the binary search tree, and which will get attached as a right child of 20. If 30 is inserted first, no doubt again it will attach as a right child because it is greater than 20, and then 10 inserted, it will get attached as a left child. So anyway, In the sequence 10 and 30 inserted, the tree will be as it is, and if the sequence is 30 and 10, tree will be as it is. And now let's consider 30 as a root node. So if 30 as a root node, next inserted number is 20, will attach as a left child of 30. Next inserted number is 10, will get attached as a left child of 20, because both the numbers are less than 30. And the next possibility is, after 30, if I'll insert 10, it will get attached as a left child of 30, and after that, if I'll insert 20, it will get attached as a right child of 10, because 20 is greater than 10 but less than 30. So it will belong to the left subtree of 30 but as a right child of 10. So in this way, if three elements are there in my binary search tree, so maximum 5 different possibilities are there in which I can construct a binary search tree by considering every as a root node. 10 as a root node, 2 possibilities are there. 20 as a root node, single possibility is there. 30 as a root node, again 2 possibilities are there. Now why? I am going to explain all these things, because these things will require for the construction of optimal binary search tree. This is the base to go for the optimal binary search tree. Now we'll go forward to the next slide. So what my next slide is going to explain. Now if I am having a binary search tree, binary search is basically used for searching. Now till now all of us are knowing, if I want to search any of the key in my given set of values, I can apply either the linear search or a binary search. Linear search, there is no any sorting required. Binary search, the sorted data is required. The another way to search the key is nothing but a binary search tree. So how to search, or how the binary search tree is helpful to search any of the key? As we are having any of the binary search tree, by applying its property, that is, all the elements in the left hand side are less than root, all the elements in the right side of a root are greater than root. By applying this property, we can perform the searching operation on a binary search tree. So now what is the cost for that searching of any key in a given binary search tree? Whatever the previous 5 different trees we have constructed will take the help of all these trees to explain the cost of searching of any key in given different binary search trees. So cost is what? The cost of searching any key is dependent on the comparisons required for searching any key element in the tree. So we are having tree, we are having a key element which I want to search, and to search that particular key, how many comparisons you will require is nothing but the cost of a searching. And if I want to find out the cost of searching of the whole tree, then I need to find out the average cost of a searching of all the keys, that I am going to explain now. So now let's consider, this is my first tree and this is my table, where I am explaining that the first column is nothing but the key, second column is number of comparisons are required. The number of comparisons are required are basically the levels on which that particular key is located, because if the number I want to search in the given tree is 10, the key is 10, which is present at a root position or a level 1, so a single comparison is required for the searching number 10 in my tree. If I want to search 20, I will compare it with first of all 10, then I will go to the right subtree of 10 because it is greater than 10. So minimum 2 comparisons it will take to search the key 20 in my tree. That's why for 20, 2 comparisons are required. Same thing for 30. If you want to search 30, I'll go first of all for comparison with the root node. It is greater than 10, so it will go to the next level and it will compare with the next node, that is 20. Again, it is greater than 20, it will go to the next node, and now here search is successful. So for every successful search, the Number of comparisons required are nothing but the level at which that key number is present. If it is 10, the number of comparisons required are 1. If it is 20, number of comparison required are 2. And if it is 30, number of comparison required are 3. So average cost, if I want to find out the average cost, so what I'll do, I'll perform addition and I'll divide it by 3. So the average cost of searching for all the key for the given tree, binary search tree, is 2. Now for the second way in which we can construct a binary search tree is nothing but the, again, root node 10, and the rest of 2 values are there. This table will explain how the comparisons are there, or how many comparisons are required to search 10. It is 1 again. For 20, it is present in the leaf position, that is third level, that's why 3 number of comparisons are required. And for 30, again 2. So average cost, average comparison cost for this tree is nothing but 2. The next one, the next tree, third tree is there for this. This is the table in which for 10, it is present at the second level, that's why 2 comparisons are required. For 20, it is present at the root level, that's why single comparison required. For 30, again it is present at level 2, that's why 2 comparisons are required. Here you can see that the addition is 5 divided by t is 1, 3 is 1.66. You can see that this value, the average searching cost, is less than the previous 2 trees. Now go forward for the rest of 2 trees. We'll see that the which one is having the less cost of comparison or less cost of searching. So this is my fourth tree. Here you can see that 10 is present at level 3, that's why 3 comparison. 20 at the middle position, 2 comparison. 30 at the root position, that's why single comparison. So again the cost, average cost, is 2. And the last tree where the comparisons required are, for 10 it is 2, for 20 it is 3, 1, 2 and 3, and for 30, as it is root node, so that's why single comparison. So again the average cost is 2. Here you can see that for the first tree, the average cost is 2. For the second tree, again average cost is 2. For fourth tree, average cost is 2. And the last tree is, again, the average cost is 2. You can see that only the tree number 3 is there, who is having the searching cost, average searching cost is 1.66, which is less than the rest of all 4 trees. Here the same thing I am going to explain. The third tree is balanced tree because average of comparison is less, as well as its height is less. Because of both the reason, we can say that this tree number 3, is the most balanced tree. But this is not our requirement. Our requirement is to find out the optimal binary search tree. So we'll go forward for the optimal binary search tree, where here you can see that here I have used the cost of searching of the numbers. If I'll include the frequencies also, in which how many times you are going to search any particular element, then that will be helpful to find out the optimal binary search tree. Now let in the next slide, I am going to use the same thing, that is, the keys are given over here along with their frequencies of searching. Frequency of searching the element 10 is 3, frequency of searching the element 20 is 2, and frequency of searching element 30 is 6. So here we'll see that how to use these frequencies to find out the optimal binary search tree. Here I'm going to use these frequencies along with the level in which the key values are located. So now here we can see that the 10, key 10, is having frequency 3, means 3 times 10 is going to be searched. So that's why 3 multiplied by its level equal to 3. 20, it's having frequency 2, so that's why 2, its level is 2, 2 to the 4. For 30, frequency is 6, that's why 6 multiplied by 3 is equal to 18. So here you can see that the total cost of tree is 25. We are performing addition of these three numbers to get the total cost. This is the second tree where you can see that 3 multiplied by 1, because 10 is present at position 1 or on the level 1, its frequency is 3 equal to 3. 30, its frequency is 6, present at level 2, is equal to 12. And 20, its frequency is 2, present at level 3, is equal to 6. So total cost is 21. Here you can see that the total cost is 20. You can calculate over here. I am going to pause here for 2 to 3 seconds. You can see that. And now next we will see the next tree, the fourth tree having the total cost 19. Again, you can verify it, you can check it. And last, the total cost of the last tree is 18, where 30 is a root node with the frequency 6 and at level 1, that's why 6. 10 is at position 2 or level 2 and its frequency is 3, so that's why 3 2s are 6. And the last one, 20, where 2 multiplied by 3 is equal to 6. In this way, the total cost of this tree is 18. And here you can compare the cost of all the tree, and at the end you can see that this is the tree having the minimum cost, which is dependent on the frequencies. So minimum searching cost is low. It means that it is a optimal binary search tree. So here what I want to say, the if the searching cost is minimum or low, it means that this tree is the optimal binary search tree, which will give the searching results in very, or it gives the best result for the searching where the cost will be very less. The another thing is the same thing, tree 5 is having minimum searching cost, that is 15. So here I can declare that tree 5 is the optimal binary search tree. But previously what we have seen, that the tree 3 was the balanced tree. It was height balanced tree, but the searching cost is only the 20, which is greater than 18. So that's why this tree is not optimal binary search tree. But according to frequencies, we can see that the tree is having the minimum cost. That's why here, though it is not a height balanced tree, still it is the optimal binary search tree. And with these different examples, we need to keep one point in our mind, is that the highest frequency key must be a root node. Here you can see that the 30 is there, which is the highest frequency number, that is present at the root position. And the lowest frequency key must be a child node or a leaf node. We can see that leaf node, not only child, we can say that child, but it is a leaf node. So it should be a leaf node. Then and then only the total cost of the tree is going to become minimum, and the lowest searching cost is nothing but the optimal binary search tree. So this is very simple example. I'll try to explain you the another example in my next video series. Thank you dear friends for listening my video. Please do not forget to give the comment. If you like the content and the video, please like my video, subscribe my channel Tech Talks, and share it with your friends. Do not forget to keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give the notification of new videos to you. Here I am giving you the subscription link to my channel, as well as some of the another videos for your reference. Thank you.